But at the beginning of this conference, please allow me to take you back to exactly 1 year ago, to the afternoon of the 24th of May 2014, a Saturday our country is not likely to forget. It was the evening before the Belgian parliamentary elections. A few hours before the last election debate was about to start on television, news came in about a shooting at the Jewish museum here in Brussels. A man had shot four people and run away. Footage of security cameras show a man walking into the museum, taking a Kalashnikov out of his bag, firing repeatedly and walking right out. It immediately became clear that it wasn't an ordinary shootout, but a terrorist attack on a Jewish target. In Marseille, French customs could arrest a suspect a week later. Mehdi Nemouch, a French citizen of almost 30 years old, who returned from Syria. Afterwards, the man was extradited to our country and charged with murder in a terroristic context. The attack was a shock for our country, not only because four people died, but most of all because we were confronted with a terrorist attack which seemed to be organized on an international level, influenced by ideology. The attack at the Jewish Museum convinced us even more to make the battle against radical and violent extremism and terrorism a top priority for the federal government, in which I am taking on the role of Minister of Security and Home Affairs for 6 months already. During these 6 months, we received a few other wake-up calls as well. Shortly after New Year, we were startled by the insane attack on Charlie Hebdo and the hostage-taking in a Jewish supermarket in Paris. After that, the attacks in Denmark and Tunis came. In our own country, we could dismantle a terroristic cell at the city of Verviers thanks to weeks of strict planning and preparation. At that rate in Verviers, luckily, no dead or wounded were counted except on terrorist side. But since that day, the Belgian people became even more vigilant. As a minister, the question that concerns me every day is, what can we do to cut off violent extremists and terrorists to the fullest? I do not want to be as naive as to think that we can open up the idealistic levels of thinking of Islamic State and similar organizations. Their anti-Semitism is not easy to be erased. Neither are we going to solve the Israeli-Palestinian conflict that has been an international war zone for 100 years already from this small country out. What we can do, and where I, as minister, really can contribute, are two big fields of action. Namely, first, work to improve the level of security to the fullest extent, even though a zero risk is totally impossible. And second, never pass on an opportunity to uphold and assert our own values and standards for whom we fought for centuries. Let me start with security. Within 24 hours after the attempted attack in our country, the federal government has announced a package of 12 measurements. As we speak, those measurements are made operationally one by one. One of these measurements states that we adapt our legislation to be able to punish terrorism more effectively. There is an expansion of the possibilities for the withdrawal of the Belgian nationality, and we made sure that we have the option to temporarily withdraw the identity cards or passports of people who form a risk. Withdraw the identity cards, you have to know that with the simple Belgian identity card, you can travel from here, from this country, to the borders of Syria and Iraq in Turkey. So it's important that when we have signals of radicalization, that we can pull in the identity card of these youngsters. Other measurements are, for example, the optimization of the information exchange between different services and governments and the military intervention. Since mid-January, military personnel is responsible for the security of sensitive buildings and locations who are under an increased level of threat. This includes, for example, the international institutions and embassies, but also Jewish synagogues and institutions as well in Brussels as in Antwerp. Just last Thursday, the whole government decided to keep the soldiers on the streets for at least another month. Even our Prime Minister, Mr. Charles Michel, announced last week that the government will provide the necessary financial means for the extra security of the buildings and institutions of the Jewish community in our country. For those who might still have any doubts, for us it is intolerable that complete communities were to feel unsafe and take that as an opportunity to leave our country. It's intolerable. If we want to win the battle against fundamentalism and terrorism, we will need to work together on a European level. We must exchange data as much as we can. On a European level, I want to compel the airline companies to share their passenger data with the government, always with respect to the personal privacy. Based on the PNR data, the passenger name records, we can narrow the international mobility of criminals drastically. Of course, the security of our physical outer borders is a top priority. Together with the people of Frontex, the EU agency that is responsible for the surveillance of the Schengen borders, I want to look at the possibilities to make sure that criminals don't get the chance to walk in and out of our territory unscreened. But as I already stated a few moments ago, security is only one side of the coin. We not only need to attack repressive, but we need to work preventive as well, to make sure to defuse the ideological situation. I find it extremely important that we promote our democratic values and norms even more than what we are doing today. Our values and norms form an antidote for the messages that those preachers of hate are disseminating. Today, a lot of Muslim youngsters only hear one side of the story, one ideology. We need to invest in gaining access to their bubble. At the end of last year, my colleague ministers of Home Affairs have given me the assignment to work on a project for the whole of Europe. I urge us to involve all different religious communities of our country in our actions, including the Muslim community. I say it at every chance I get, the battle against jihad terrorism is not a battle of us against the Muslim community, but of all of us, Muslims included, against the terrorists who are nothing more than real criminals. For that, we must join efforts, all together, beyond the borders of people and ideologies. We cannot let extremists who don't mean well with us and the rest of the world and question our fundamental values, we cannot let these guys play us against each other. To this, I refuse to comply. That's the main message I want to pass on to each of you at the beginning of this important conference. I already want to thank you very warmly for the level of thinking and the exchange of ideas that are about to happen here. You can always count on my willingness to listen to new ideas. I thank you all very much.